Man, what does that say there? Find a way to get inside what, the cubicle? Okay, let's see, we washed our teeth already, we have to use the toilet and take a shower. Gotcha. What, this dirty old thing? Do I just sit in here? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, look at the teddy. He's having a go at it. Oh, it's us. Is it us? That we're crying. Do you want some toilet paper, Teddy? Okay. The door is locked. The door is locked from the inside. Yeah. It's okay, Teddy. Oh, shit. The anxiety is kicking in again. Go away, please. Oh. Okay. Alright, so I guess I use the toilets. Yep. Now let's take a shower. Oh my god, this is not creepy at all. I guess this is us here. Open this up. Okay, this works now. Let's close this. Close it. Get our soap. Let us lather ourselves nicely. Damn, these kids are some little shits. What the fuck, man? They just assaulted me in the shower. Run away, escape from here, run. Yeah, you don't have to tell me that twice. There's a trail of blood. Oh god. Shit. I'm out of here, fuck this shit. See you later. Ah, oh, I can't. Damn it. Okay. Maybe through here?
Children should not be out at night. Get back to your dorm.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, okay. On you. I remember the Full Metal Jacket movie, thinking about doing the same things they did to Gunner, whatever was his name. No, I think it was a Joker, was it? Anyways, just get a bunch of soaps and go hell on these kids. Oh, look at this one. This is my room. Yeah, this is my bedroom. A bunk. Just wanna see if there's anything else around. Okay, let's go here. I don't have a single friend in this orphanage. It's quite fucking sad. No wonder this guy has some deep traumas. No one has anything interesting in their drawers, so I'm just gonna go to bed, I think. Oh, the teddy's all fucked up. My only friend. Good God, I can't even imagine what it is to go through something like this. Fuck. Another day in paradise. Here we go.
Breakfast is ready. Come downstairs.
Oh no. Enough. I remember. Oh, I think John has had enough of remembering the childhood memories. He wants out, yeah. Okay. Get out of here, shall we? It's again the chair with an IV. I sit on it? Yeah. Oh, don't tell me. No, maybe I'm just reading it into it too much, but did he jump out the window or something? Is that window opening up to a bright... I don't know. Maybe I'm reading too much into it. The patient has submitted to the truth. However far back it may be, one illusion of his mind's perfect world has been revealed. The next attempt must be delicate. His mind will be alert. Okay, so... he was thinking back, he remembered.
Your childhood was cruel. I know you went through a lot of pain. I needed you to remember something real. Imagining a child's paradise can be painless for the mind, but the truth is rarely painless. You remembered, even though there was pain. We must find the truth. One more question, John. Do you remember the last game you played?
Yeah, I can't say that I do. That's one of the most amazing things about the human minds. How moldable it is, how pliable it can become. And actually, you can't even trust your own memories. They can be something else completely different.
Playing games is just a distraction, John.
All right. So what did we play next? Last. treasure hunting, I think? I don't remember ever going up in a balloon, so.
Thank you, John. John, I want to try something new. I want you to try and clear your mind. Just like a blank sheet of paper, I'd like you to imagine anything you want. And take me there. It can be anything, John.
Okay. Let's see what he comes up with. Our memories of our childhood are not locked. Okay, let's check out the bust, shall we? Well, it's getting there. Can I open this up yet? No.
I want you to submit to the memory.
It was a beautiful day on the beach. Could feel the sun on his face and hear the sounds of the sea. As he looked out from his palace, he thought to himself, a glass of wine would be perfect. Oh, this is actually quite lovely. Exactly like that. Perfect. Uh-oh. Are we getting into the root of our deep...
Why did it stop, John?
Alcoholism.
Is there nothing else that comes to mind? What about me? Am I real? Can you recall?
I don't actually know.
Yes, John. I remember that day well. Do you recall what we spoke about?
No. Do I have to make a guess?
That one in particular is special.
What does it look like to you? To me, it looks like a bat. Maybe a butterfly. Oh, there's more over there. Excuse me. Is this the waiting room? What, for the doctor's office? Am I registering or visiting? Visiting. 003. Wait, is this John Evans' patient?
Good, John. Follow the memory.
Are we in a psychiatric ward? Because we did try to kill ourselves. With the car. Enter. Okay, it's the same thing. Or we can just slide the cards. But do I have a card? Not really sure. John Evans. What does that say there? Dr. Richards? Yeah. 13th of June 1970. That was when I was a kid, right? That one says the same thing. Doctor's office. Go in there.
Welcome back, Mr. Evans. Please, take a seat.
Looks like we're being examined. Act 3, two poles. The therapy continues to progress. The patient's mind is quick to embrace emptiness. The stimulus of our past as it was able to transcend the walls. He has reached a critical crossroads. Emptiness or the truth?
Welcome back, Mr. Evans. Please, take a seat.
Oh, look at this. That's the file we're looking at. It doesn't have anything. Maybe this was when we were admitted. Still very new. Can I open any more drawers? No. Yep, I'll take a seat in a minute. Oh, that's the Xylatropran thing there. What did that say? Oh, okay. Admitted to the branch. January 13, 1920. 20 years old. Damn.
How are you doing today?
Fine.
All right. And how about your daily routine? Did you have a chance to try my advice?
Not yet.
Remember to at least try, Mr. Evans. The first step comes from within. All right, let's start something new for this session. I'm sure you've seen these before.
Oh, yeah.
It's quite simple.
Rorschach drawings.
I'd like to ask you some questions about what you see. Don't worry about your answers. There is no wrong choice. Take your time.
Okay.
First, tell me what you see.
Well, this one, let's see. Two people carrying something.
Do they seem happy to you?
Yeah. Oh. Why would you be happy doing that? I don't think so.
And what do you think the red means?
Maybe they're sweating a lot? Love? Love.
Last question. Do you see yourself there?
Not at all.
Thank you, Mr. Evans. Interesting.
Is it?
It's very important that we have structure in our lives. And a job is a great way to start a healthy routine. I've marked some jobs I think you would be good at.
Creative writer.
Take a look.
Finance
Maybe
analyst?
Something will catch your eye. I look forward to seeing you again.
Is the government spying on you? Mobile CCTV. Wake up, people. Birds are not real. What? The activists are suggesting to observe these animals carefully. Have you ever encountered a pigeon which was looking at you for no reason while simply eating a sandwich on a bench? Why would they do that except to keep you under surveillance? Like that. Butterfly invasion. Is this why we're trying to write stuff so desperately? To maybe grasp at some sort of routine to keep us sane? What did he write on there? Nothing, it looks like. What the fuck? Psychotherapy, isolation wards, medical consultation, rehabilitation, x-ray. This is a fucking... The passage is locked. Oh, it's locked here as well. What the? Can't really go back. Shall I call someone? I think this is a psychiatric ward. Do I have a room here? Oh god. Having for dinner some pills. Oh god. Waiting room. Chapter 1, the job search. What is that? Feel better. Some chocolates, maybe? What do I do here? I do love me some drawers to open. We still have our comb, that's nice to see, and the Walkman. And the picture of the teddy. That's nice. Charles W. White, Fighting Anxiety. We've seen this book before. Okay, I should get started. Now hiring. We are now hiring. Join our team, yeah. Okay, shall I just sit down? Okay, turn this on. Show new offers. There's never anything for me. Physician assistant, software engineer, business development manager. All pretty good jobs. Creative writing. Creative writer, that's one there. What's happening here? Oh my goodness. Oh, it's a bunch of professions. Okay. So, no cooking for me. No working as a construction. No welding. No plumbing. Janitor. Doctor. No way. Couldn't be the janitor. Too much work. I wanna be a good welder. Doctor. Too much responsibility. Hire yourself. Your dream job is just waiting around the corner. Right. This could be interesting. Maybe if I can write something. After days of searching for clues, the detective finally got a break in the form of a cryptic note. Follow the blue balloon tonight at 9 PM. Okay. Oh, there it is. That's one strong ass balloon. Shall we follow it? The frick? Oh, everything's coming undone again. Can I go through here? Right. The air was electric and the night held its breath. The air stood up on the back of his neck as he stepped forwards. A shot rang out. The cold body didn't offer answers, but he didn't need them anyway. He finally found the lead. Now the work can begin. Even a short story about egg dogs. I'm not sure what is that. That's the crime scene, alright. Just making sure it's empty. Okay. Oh, looks like we can apply for creative writing now. Mail sent. Oh yeah. What happens? Am I okay? It's just a routine exam, hopefully. Nothing here. Sad.
It's good to see you, Mr. Evans.
Oh, it's you again.
How are you feeling?
A little better, yeah.
And how did the job search go? Did you find anything?
I tried. Maybe there's something?
Good. That's the spirit. Okay, Mr. Evans. How about we try another ink blot?
Okay, sure.
Same as before. I'll ask some questions, and there are no wrong answers.
Two dudes high-fiving. Two pandas high-fiving. A screaming face. Two bears fighting. Okay, two bears fighting.
How does that make you feel?
Scared.
And what about now? What do you see?
Two pandas dancing. Moth, butterfly, moth.
Thank you. Quite interesting. A change in perspective can be powerful.
Indeed.
That's enough for today. I wish you good luck, Mr. Evans. I think you want the job more than you let show, which isn't a bad thing. We'll meet again, the same time next week.
Try to see. It doesn't write anything on it. I think it's just pretending. Maybe it's not even real. It's a phony ass doctor. Okay, let's see if we get the job. Which I'm almost. Almost confident that we won't. Where are we going? Here? Where does this lead? Rehabilitation. I'm scoring some pills here. No. Waiting room. Doctor's office. Chapter 2, the interview. Oh god. This is not going to make me nervous or anything. The door is locked. I just gotta wait.
Who's next?
There we go, that's us.
Mr. John Evans.
Oh god, the anxiety. Yep, yep, yep. Oh, excuse me. Get out of the way! Come on!
Mr. Evans!
Just gotta force ourselves into it, I guess.
Please, sit down.
Oh my god.
Okay, Mr. Evans. Let's cut right to the chase.
It's not intimidating whatsoever.
Let's take a look at your resume.
There's not much there, but...
Not exactly the qualifications we're looking for.
Well, it's creative writing. What do you want? Give me
a
break.
How about the short story from the job posting?
Yeah, sure. Can I read it first, actually? If today's a... so that's what we were writing. Now the work can begin. The next day, a heavy fog hung over the town. Nobody dared to leave the house. Everyone was afraid that the killer would start another hunt. Detective Spark woke up on the bench outside the police station. He had to talk to the chief of police, and he talked, but he didn't remember that now. He actually didn't remember anything from last night. In search of cigarettes, he reached into the inside of his coat. He found a drawing, blue balloon drawing. Spark has had a problem with addiction for a long time. He was also addicted to his work. He promised himself that he must solve the case. And just now, when he looked at the drawing, he remembered everything. After a while, he realized his unfortunate position. He started running across the fog toward the house. I mean, it's okay, I guess. It's not my best work, but I can do better, I promise.
You wrote this?
Yeah.
It's not bad, but I'm not convinced. How about you prove to me, right here, right now, that you've got the skills?
Oh, it's too much pressure, dude. What the fuck?
Write us a short story. Any topic.
Oh, God. Alright, here goes nothing. Sometimes the best choice is to hide. You can hear the beast coming, but there's nothing you can do. So you choose to hide and pray it passes you by. There wasn't any time to save anyone else. You would tell yourself until the end of days. The only thing is, if you ask anyone else, they would tell you. Locking you away was the best thing they ever did. Oh, that is actually very interesting.
I think that's enough.
That's actually
a little cliche, but well written.
Much better than the other one.
Welcome aboard, John. You've got the job.
Oh, nice. Please, let's not fuck this up. I mean, I'm sure we will. We're back in the doctor's office.
Hello, Mr. Evans. Nice to see you again. How are you doing?
Much better, yeah.
And did you have the job interview? How did it go?
His mug says, keep talking, I'm diagnosing you. It was scary, but I got it.
Congratulations, Mr. Evans. That's great news. Let's continue our work with the ink blots. I know they're confusing, but I think we're making progress. What comes to mind when you look at this?
I'm always going for, maybe wolves this time. Some kind of animal. Wolves swimming? Panthers climbing a mountain. Yeah, that's trapped dragon.
What name would you give this picture?
The Journey.
Would you associate this with weakness or strength?
Strength.
Last question, Mr. Evans. Which would you choose to be?
Oh.
A dragon or a panther?
That's just a very deep question right there. Hell's a dragon, yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Evans. That's enough for now. I think we're getting somewhere.
Me
Good
too.
Luck at your new job. I look forward to hearing about it.
Looks like I'd rather be a dragon than being a human. Okay, let's see how this job thing pans out. Let's begin our journey of sorts. Climb the mountain as the graceful panther, just to emerge as a powerful dragon. His face. Man, he's got an amazing voice. Is anyone in? Hello? Chapter 3, The Office. The most terrible poverty is loneliness and the feeling of being unwanted. Mother Teresa. So our job is just to write short stories? That's pretty cool. Must be exhausting though, coming up with the something brand new every day, though. Work rules. A work is set up on the disk, marked employee name. The disk can be found in the work cabinet in the hallway. All employees need to finish all their tasks before 5 o'clock.
Let's get started, John. You'll find everything you need on your disk.
Okay. Where's my disk? In the work cabinets, in the hallway. Gotcha. The only way to do great work and achieve success is to love what you do. Indeed. Oh. What are you looking at? Go back to work. Gotcha. Sorry about that. I guess that's the cabinet there. Yeah. John Evans. Can I get a cup of coffee? Start my day right? Nope. Maybe some wine? Yep. No one likes to be interrupted in their cubicle. Alright, so insert work disk. Task for today, children's story. Click to continue. Creating new file. Once upon a time, there was a young boy whose dream was to become... do I get to decide? Was to become a sailor. No? Yeah, continue to write. Why did we stop? I didn't get that. Oh, here we go. A king or a knight? A knight. A brave knight. I wanted to dance. Okay, yeah, do I do anything else? Is there no one in this cubicle? One day, while he was resting on a hammock, wake him up. A royal messenger came to him with a message. On behalf of the king, the following is announced. The royal princess was brutally kidnapped by a monster living in the cursed cave. The one who dares to defeat the monster and save the princess will become a knight of the king. Defeat the beast. The boy, however, needed a proper weapon to fight the beast, but where could he find one? East or west? Let's go east. He decided to go deep into the forest in search of a weapon. Well, we're really taking creative writing to another ball game here. After a few days of wandering in the woods, our hero finally found a magical well. According to old stories, the well could fulfill any wish, but only under full moon. Oh, I have to go there now? Okay. Oops. I'm writing the story. Can't. No, wait. Ah, now we can make a wish. So the boy asked for a magical bow and arrows to defeat the monster, and the well fulfilled his wish. The boy was ready to fight. Oh, we fell asleep. Oh no.
Evans! You know I love the creativity, but I need you to focus on the job. This is an important one for us.
Did I write anything at all? Or was I just sleeping this whole time and imagining it? I hope I was. Oh, we're going back to the office.
Good afternoon, Mr. Evans. Please, make yourself comfortable. So, tell me, how are you feeling about your new job?
It's better than nothing.
Progress takes effort and time, Mr. Evans. It pays off in the long term. I think one day you'll agree with me. Do you think staying still would have been better than what you've achieved?
No, absolutely not.
Fair enough, Mr. Evans. We can keep going.
Yes, we can.
We have one more ink blot to look at. I think you'll like this one.
Okay.
Do you see anything familiar?
No. A volcano exploding? Life in the ocean? Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Is there chaos or order?
I would say it's a natural chaos.
And how does that make you feel?
At home.
Thank you. Those responses have been very enlightening. You've come a long way in these last sessions, Mr. Evans. Our time is up for today. But I want you to keep your mind open to new opportunities.
Okay. Thank you, Doctor. I'm feeling a lot better, actually. Well, at least I hope I am. Chapter 4, Home. There's our printing. We don't need glasses anymore. Where's the freaking alarm clock? Here we go. Let's turn that off. Very neatly tidied away the shirt. Turn this on. That's a pizza. Pizza and Chinese foods. Classic. I need to do some laundry tonight. Oh, okay. Close this. There we go. Nice. You again? Can I open this? Can't really slide that. What the fuck? Why is there an intercommunicator in my room?
Call from the client. I know it's Saturday, but we really need the next chapter of the story by 5 p.m. today. I'm counting on you, John. I see bright things in the future for you.
Oh, come on, dude. It's the weekend. Who needs the story by a Saturday? Come on. I can do it. I just need to focus and some peace and quiet. Oh, this is where it all started. Prison was no home. The visitors were still welcome. What is that noise? turn off. Someone playing piano in the next room? Use the broom, yeah. Quiet there, I need to work. Good, now I can get in. Off. Who might it be?
Sorry about the noise. I just moved on upstairs and I don't want to start off on the wrong foot with anyone. Let me know if it gets too loud again.
Oh, the anxiety. The butterflies in the stomach. What the fuck? Well, that's not good.